Welcome to Beyond the Breast channel.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And today we are going to test, can you tenderize a steak with deep sea chamber? And here is our deep sea chamber, 10 million. It goes up to 3 kilometers or 2 miles of depth. And that's 300 bars of pressure, so it's a lot. And the idea is pretty simple. We have two steaks. And these are vacuum packet, so there isn't any air inside of the packet, so that's not going to be a problem. And one of these, let's say this one, goes here inside of the chamber. And then we just close this end and pressurize it fast. I think it's better to go fast. I think the time doesn't help. The faster you go, the better. And we can go quite fast. I think we can go from 0 to 300 in half a second. So that's not going to be possible in the like real ocean and submarines or anything like that. So this is the best case scenario of tenderizing your steak using water pressure. And what is on your idea? Is it going to do anything for the steak?
No.
I'm going to say that there is going to be a small difference. And we are going to find out because we have two of these. And this one doesn't go in. And then when that's treated and this not, we are going to cook these and taste and tell you, is this new kitchen innovation that you need?
Really cheap and easy to use.
Yeah, we have made actually some upgrades. As you can see, we have now stainless steel ends made in Argos hydraulic. And then we are going to replace the tape with Loctite 577. This is rated for 3-inch threads, so it should be good with this, and this can also take the pressure, so no more leaks or rusting ends. And I haven't glued up the window to this end, so I think today we are going to still use the old end, because this didn't leak even with tape. Yeah, but hey, no more talking. I'm going to screw this in, we are going to fill this with water, and then we see. Okay, we had a hose explosion, luckily with garden hose, so not that bad situation. I got a little bit wet. Yeah, but hey, this is now closed, so I'm going to just fix this and then we're going to fill it up and pressurize. Okay, this is now ready, and if you want to like better description how this works, I have whole video about this, but shortly this is going to crush this cylinder. And then the cylinder is going to turn the force into pressure, goes through the hose inside of the thing. And then we have one window for light and second for the camera. And I forgot to put one of these there to block the light. So the picture isn't perfect now, but it's not the, like today's main mission to see what's going to happen there. Nothing much is going to happen, but the end result is more interesting. And since this is pretty experimental system, everything is rated for 300 bars, but to be completely safe, we are going to go like behind the corner. So if the hose explodes or something, we are not going to be near. Yeah. And this is set for 100 bars. And because this has 3 times the area than this, it's going to multiply the pressure from 100 bars to 300 bars. Yes, so let's go. And here we go. Okay, small leak on the tape end, but that was like expected. We have to glue also that, but the glue helps really well. But there is now 300 bars. Should I, Anni, keep it a little bit longer still?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think the steak is ready. Let's open it. Yeah, my phone got a little bit like high pressure washing action. Luckily it should be waterproof. Yeah, but the problem with the tape is that it's not rated for these large threads. It's meant for smaller ones. But for the next video, I'm going to also glue this end. Yeah, but I'm now going to now pop these open and then we get the steak out. Okay, here it comes. Looks exactly the same as before. This has been like, check the etiquette. It got like somehow, I'm not sure, is it just the water or is it also the pressure, but this is like coming loose. But this is completely intact and looks exactly the same. Hey, yeah, but now we are going to continue from kitchen. Okay, we are on the kitchen, and on this point I have to say that for some reason this has pepper and this doesn't, and it was like this when we bought these, but they are the same type of meat and from the same pile. I think there's just two like seasoning options, but now we are going to pop these open and cook piece from the each packet, and then we are going to taste. Ta-da! Moment of the truth. Are they any different? So this is non-pressure cooker and this is pressure cooker. And I add the pepper also here to make them equal. Then some salt. Yeah, that's good. Hey, let's first try this. And I have two, one is a bit more medium and one is well done.
Pretty good.
Okay, these are both a bit overcooked. And so thin. I still like. Okay. I think this was first out. This is a bit thicker piece than this, so this is not so well done. But I have to say, there's absolutely zero difference.
Yeah.
It is, it's so basic steak, there isn't anything.
Yeah. Or maybe we are just steak amateurs.
Yeah, that's true also. Yeah, the taste, completely normal. Texture, completely normal. Cooking. Completely normal. I don't see any yeah. differences.
But more work.
Yeah, like way more work. So the steak doesn't get any more tender if you pressure treat it like this. If you have ideas of other foods or similar tricks that we should try with the chamber, please let us know. But I think the next video is going to be product testing. I have dive watches and dive like flashlights, and we are going to test those next time with proper pressure meter and slower pressurizing, so you can see where they break. Yeah, but at least we got some food in company's expenses, so great victory. Yeah, but that is all for today.
Thanks for watching
and have a nice day.